So my morning routine obviously starts the night before. I treat Instacart like it's a real job. I've worked it both full-time and part-time over the past 2 years. As far as what I wear, obviously you wanna be comfortable, you know, depending on where you work in the United States. You wanna wear something that you're gonna be able to move around in all day for, you know, 8 hours, or depending on how long you're gonna work. Sometimes in the morning while I'm getting ready, I'll look at batches and see if something good pops up, but I'll focus more on getting ready and getting out the door. That way I can get to one of the stores that's open already. My name is Matt Kirk, I'm 25 years old, and I'm gonna show you how you can make $104,000 a year, all from Instacart. So my morning routine always starts the night before. I try to prep everything that I'm gonna wear the next day, all the things that I'm going to need, plug in my portable charger because I don't know how long I'm gonna be out in the field. As far as what I wear, obviously you wanna be comfortable, you know, depending on where you work in the United States. You wanna wear something that you're gonna be able to move around in all day for, you know, 8 hours, or depending on how long you're gonna work. But more than comfortability, I focus on looking good. Now obviously you're not gonna have to wear something that you would to a normal 9-to-5, but when you're going out looking like garbage, how can you expect somebody to give you an extra tip at the door or increase the tip later because you look professional doing your job? Early on in the week, I try to get out of the house by 6 a.m. and get to one of the stores that's open, which is usually Smart and Final down here in San Diego, get a batch, that way I can get the day rolling and start off strong. A lot of the main big orders can come from Costco or one of those other huge, you know, bulk stores. And usually right around 10 a.m. is when Instacart gets flooded with a bunch of Costco orders, and usually that's when you're gonna get your biggest order of the day. That's why it's important to get out of the house early and do as many orders as you can before 10 a.m. So in my opinion, rather than taking a $40 order and delivering it after 10 a.m., it's important to just focus on getting yourself to Costco, because I've gotten some of my biggest orders right as soon as 10 a.m. hits. Every day I set a quota for myself. About a year ago, my quota was $134 every single day. $134 for 7 days a week, or for 30 days a month, is technically $1,000 a week, or $4,000 a month. My quota eventually was 200, and then about 2 weeks later, it was 300. Where I get the number $104,000 in a year all stems from $286 a day, which means if you're working 7 days a week on Instacart, you have to make $286 to make $2,000 at the end of that week. Now, when you multiply $2,000 by 52 weeks, which is the amount of weeks in a year, you get $104,000. Now, during COVID, everybody on Instacart was given a 5-star rating, which was basically giving you the opportunity to get a huge amount of orders all throughout the day, no matter the time. It was literally first come, first serve. Now, everybody that worked for Instacart had a 5-star ranking all until about 2 weeks ago. So obviously, when you're not a 5-star rank, it's gonna be extremely difficult to make $2,000 every single week. And the tough part is, that's really out of your control as a shopper. It's a lot harder to get good orders when you're not at a 5-star ranking. I experienced this firsthand this week. I'll show you guys a couple screenshots of the days I had on Tuesday and Wednesday, which were my toughest days this past week, but I was just adamant on making $2,000 this week and showing you guys in this video, so I basically pushed all day until like 10 o'clock. Now, usually before I get in the store, I send out a customized message to each person that I'm shopping for. Now, I don't take the time to write these personal messages out. What I do is I have them saved in my notes, the pre and post message. I just copy it, I plug it in, and the only thing that I change is usually the person's name and what time of day it is. Now, if I have the words, "Hey, good morning, John," in my pre-message, I'm going to change the name from John to whoever I'm shopping for. And then obviously once it's the afternoon, you change the morning to the afternoon. It's little details like this that's gonna show the customer that you're going above and beyond for them, and they're gonna be even more likely to leave you positive feedback as well as a 5-star rating. And finally, after the shop is complete and I'm in the car loaded up with the groceries, I make sure and send them my post-shop message, which includes things such as, if you like this service, please leave me a rating. I don't necessarily ask for them to give me 5 stars. I would love them to, but basically what I'm saying is, hey, I did my very best for you. I gave you my best service, and this is the time I'm gonna be there. And that's also sometimes when I'll plug in, hey, I'm gonna need to scan your ID, so please have that ready for me when I get there. So after you've sent your post-shop message to the customer and you're finally on your way to deliver their groceries, here's a couple things to keep in mind. So as soon as I have all the groceries on the porch and I have my pictures, I go ahead and ring the doorbell, and if the customer opens the door, I get to have an interaction with them, say hi and usually use their name, ask them if they need help in, And then right before I leave to go back to my car, I make sure and let them know that, you know, I would really appreciate if they left me a rating and a review. I don't ask for 5 stars because obviously you're really, you know, it looks kind of tacky if you are asking for 5 stars. But if they're happy with the shop, then most of the time they're going to leave you 5 stars and a comment for you to read later on. Always make sure to be friendly and courteous at the door. And when you ask for someone to give you a rating, do it in a polite way. And a lot of times people will actually increase their tip if you focus on making sure to be nice and see if they need help in with anything and just being a good person. When I did my first order on Instacart about 2 years ago, I was trying to be as fast as possible. Since then, that I've learned that it's not just important to be fast in the store, but it's more important to get every single item on each aisle that you hit. That way you're not running across the store to different aisles, but when you do every aisle nice and slow and you make sure and hit every single item, you're gonna do that shop a lot faster than if you were just to speed down aisles and miss like 2 or 3 items on every single aisle. It's really important to know the layout of the store, so obviously that's something that's gonna come with time, but don't feel afraid to ask an employee if you need help finding something. And when it comes to employees, you really want them on your side because you most likely are gonna be in that store again, and the last thing you want is to have somebody in the store disliking you. When you're nice to them, they're gonna be nice to you. And at the end of the day, that's important to have when you're shopping in a store multiple times. Another tip for you guys should be pretty obvious, but it's to always get the frozen stuff last. I know it can be difficult when you have to get something in the very front of the store, so maybe grab that first, and then you have to go all the way back to get the ice cream or, you know, the frozen chicken nuggets. But the important thing is to make sure the items are still as cold as they can be when you deliver them to the person's house. It's something as little as melted ice cream could get your $20 tip taken away, or even worse, give you a low rating, which means you're not gonna get big orders that week. Now I have a couple tips for you guys when you're getting ready to shop your order. The first tip is to always have boxes in your car, or make sure you have boxes available when you get in the store. When you guys do shops at Costco or Sam's Club, most of the time you are only going to be able to use boxes. But when you're in other smaller grocery stores, it's still important to have boxes because you never know what kind of bags they're gonna give you or how many units you're going to have to shop. By having boxes, it can speed up the time at checkout, which means you don't have to bag a bunch of items. You can literally just put them in the box, play Tetris, and instead of having like 14 or 16 bags, you literally have 1 or 2 boxes. That's 2 trips to the house, or 1 trip to the house instead of 4. Now, another benefit to having boxes with you at all times is when you get a double or triple order. Now, I personally hate doing triple orders, but if that price comes up and you just have to take it, then sometimes you just have to take it. Having boxes can really help you separate the items, especially if you only have a cart instead of a flatbed. So let's say you grab a double order at a grocery store where a flatbed is not available and you just have a regular cart. How I would focus on doing this is putting 1 box in the main area of the cart. That way you guys can put the order that has the most items in that area and then use the top basket to place another box. That way, when you're going through the shop, you can put A in the main cart and B in the basket. By doing this throughout your shop, you're gonna be able to check out faster as well as deliver faster, which means you're going to get back to the store faster and be able to make more money. I've talked to a lot of Costco employees in the past that say they've had Instacart shoppers come up with a cart full of items and then they try to separate them as they're looking at the app while they're putting stuff on the belt, and it really makes the process slow, not only for the shopper, but for the people that are waiting in line behind them. I was a victim of this myself one time. This is at least 2 or 3 months ago. I was literally pushing a flatbed. I was behind an Instacart shopper. My order was completely separated between A and B. I had barcodes faced up and ready to check out. And I was watching her place items on the belt and look at her phone at the same time because she didn't separate it earlier on throughout the shop. Do your very best to face barcodes up. That way when you get to checkout, you don't have to have them turning over a bunch of items trying to find barcodes. And that way the employee likes you a lot more and they're like, hey, come to my line next time. I'm gonna make sure and get you on your way every single time. By keeping your orders separate throughout the shop, whether you have 2 or 3, and facing barcodes up, it's just gonna make your checkout time a lot faster, and the employee is gonna be way more happy with you because you took the time to do that before getting to the counter. So at the end of the day, those tips that I gave you are literally the tips that I follow. I set myself up for success every day by going to bed, by being able to wake up early, setting a number for myself throughout the day. And if I don't hit that quota, I just adjust the numbers and I focus on hitting a little bit higher the next day. of the main things that I want you guys to focus on out of this video. One, I really want you guys to up your customer interactions. That way you guys are making sure you guys get 5 stars, because at the end of the day, it's really all about 5 stars. When you're anything below a 498, it's gonna be very difficult to get high paying orders. And those high paying orders are the ones that get you closer and faster to 300 every single day. Make sure you guys always have boxes. Make sure you guys are being cool to the employees in the store, and make sure you guys aren't rushing through orders and stressing about items. So hopefully you guys can start implementing these tips every single day, increasing your money and getting that much closer to $100,000 a year on Instacart. My name's Matt, and thanks for watching.